It amazes me that people feel we need to say this out loud, but apparently we do. If you have pets that you're letting out to go and do their thing, bring them in. This weather will kill them. You know, we like to state it how it is. We're not going to tell you, oh, yeah, it's pretty bad. No, no, no. This weather will kill them if you leave them out there too long. All right? Bring them in. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is pretty cold out there. Walked Reagan this morning, my boy Reagan. And he has metal in it. It's a Conway family requirement, right? You have to have some metal in your body somewhere. I got two titanium rods and 8 screws in my spine. He has a plate and some screws in his rear left leg. And this time of year, boy, do we ever know about that. We really know about it. And today, had to pick him up, carry him home, my 80-pound dog. With my back issues as well. Because he just, first thing he does, he picks up that back leg and he won't put it down anymore. You know, he starts with a limp, then he picks up the back leg, then he stops. Literally stops. So I have to throw him up over my shoulders and carry my 80-pound dog home. Joining us, there he is, there's my boy Reagan, and he's listening, so he just heard himself bark, so that's good. Joining us now is Steve Goreham. He is the Executive Director of the Climate Science Coalition of America. He's author of 3 books on energy, climate change, and the sustainable development, with over 100,000 copies in print. His latest book is called Outside the Green Box. Steve Goreham, welcome back. And
Simon,
let me ask you something, right? It's it felt like minus 31 apparently this morning while I was walking my boy Reagan.
Wow.
Are we on the verge of a mini ice age?
Well, this weather is tough on man and beast. It's just amazing. I hope you're keeping warm. And yeah, once again, the climate scientists are wrong.
No.
Just to quote a book written about 2000, The Climate Crisis, by David Archer and Stefan Ramsdorf, 2 climate scientists.
Mm-hmm.
They quoted the United Nations Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, which said one of the robust findings of the report is that snow cover in most continental areas will dramatically decrease unless warming is stopped. Large areas are expected to become snow-free.
I can't remember which climate scientist said it, but one of them said, children are not going to know what snow is.
That's right. That was Dr. David Viner. I was just going to say that. He said the snowfall is going to be a very rare and exciting event. Yeah. Yeah, it is quite an accomplishment, and we're having a good old-fashioned, really cold North American winter all the way around. New York has already their snow for the winter, and Texas, they have 2,000 people without power down there. Their wind turbines are icing up.
Yes.
And their temperatures are 40 to 50 degrees below normal.
Have you seen the picture of the helicopter, you know, powered by fossil fuels, dropping the de-icer, which is made from fossil fuels, onto the wind turbine blades to make them not ice up?
To de-ice them.
Yes.
Well, yeah,
great photograph.
To get back to your question, Earth's climate, people may not know, is driven by cycles, long-term cycles that made the ice ages every 40,000, 100,000 years, according to geologists. Medium-term cycles that come every 1,000 or 1,500 years that gave us the medieval warm period when they named Greenland. And,
right.
And
there's
and
a reason it's called age. Greenland. carry on.
And then short-term cycles.
Yes.
And we have two cycles that affect our nation in the short term. One is in the Pacific Ocean. There's a temperature cycle that goes from high to low every 20 or 30 years called the Pacific Decadal Oscillation.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the Atlantic, we have another one called the Multi-Decadal Oscillation, which is a little bit longer, goes from high to low every 40, 50 years. And both of those have been in a warm phase since about 1980, but the Pacific Oscillation peaked about 2017. And now, after more than 20 years, the Atlantic Multi-Decadal Oscillation appears to be moving into a cool phase. So we got both of our oceans that are moving into a cool phase, and we may get maybe a decade of cooler temperatures.
Right, because back when Henry VIII was on the throne of England, the Thames froze over so so hard that there was a regular winter farmer's market, for want of a better description, on the Thames.
On the frozen Thames. They called it the Frost Fair. And as a matter of fact, the Thames froze at Teddington. You may know where that is. I don't know where that is, but it's south of London for the first time in more than 50 years. So, yeah, they've also had record temperatures in Spain. They had snow in Istanbul. And matter of fact, I guess in Iowa, you guys now broke a couple records on Sunday, all-time lowest temperatures.
We did. Apparently, we're
a couple other places.
Apparently, we're 20 inches of snow away from an all-time record. We're expecting more records to fall this week, cold records. Illinois as well. We've expanded the show now. We're in Illinois as well. We're in Wisconsin. We're all over the place, buddy. All over the Midwest. And there's records falling everywhere. Now, the people that think the answer to this is higher taxes, they will tell you this is why we call it climate change.
Right. Well, it's very sad that the Biden administration and others believe they can control global temperatures with laws and regulations.
And taxes.
But Earth's climate cannot be regulated by Washington, D.C. And one of these days they're going to figure that out.
Well, we figured it out. We left the Paris Climate Accords. Apparently, we're going to rejoin them. I'm not quite sure what that looks like or if that's even possible. Remember, it's not a treaty. At no point did the United States government, the Senate, the House, confirm a treaty. So there is no treaty. But we're apparently going back to doing something, which I'm not sure what the something is. But he's very anti-fossil fuels, isn't he?
Yes, he is. That's John Kerry's job, our our climate czar.
Hey, wait a minute. People like him have to take private jets. Come on. Stop picking on John.
I noticed what he said. Yeah, and one of the things that they'll probably want us to do is give a couple billion a year or more to this Green Climate Fund. That's something that really has stalled. President Obama had committed a couple billion to it, and Trump pulled it back. And around the world, they want to transfer $100 billion a year from the wealthy nations to the developing nations in the name of climate.
Mm-hmm.
Really an amazing thing. So I don't know. We'll see what Mr. Biden does, but I hope he doesn't want to send a bunch of our tax money over there again.
Probably will. One of my listeners has just sent me a copy of the front page of a magazine called Science and Mechanics, November 1969. It has artist's impression of St. Louis, Boston, New York, and Chicago. And it says, experts say a new ice age is imminent.
Yep.
That was Science and Mechanics, and because, hey, science. And, of course, in the 1970s, famously, the Newsweek, which still exists, which is perhaps more remarkable than anything else, Newsweek did something very similar. And, of course, Newsweek quoted some of the people who are now global warming people who were saying that the freeze was coming, and the way to stop it was to dump soot on the polar ice caps to melt them.
Yeah, there's all kinds of crazy ideas. You know, the evidence shows that humans are not having the human carbon dioxide is not having a measurable change on the Earth's atmosphere. But, you know, we could do some crazy things if we want to go out there. There's a bunch of guys, the guy from Microsoft, why is that escaping me? Who's the founder?
Bill Gates.
Anyway, Bill Gates, yeah, he was talking about putting a whole bunch of particles in the atmosphere and trying to stop sunlight from coming down. I mean, we could do some really crazy things.
Yes.
And if we're heading into a cold period, that would not be a good idea.
No. No. We want as much sunlight to get through as is possible. We are talking to Steve Goreham. We love having Steve on, and we like talking to him about these things. You and I have been doing this, Steve, for a long time. We've been having this conversation for a long time. Steve is a speaker. He's an author. He's the executive director of the Climate Science Coalition of America. It seems that this is now completely political.
Yeah, it is remarkable, and everybody has almost every leader now, and almost all the political parties are now have become climate alarmists. We have Most major cities in the country saying they're going to go 100% renewable. They don't have the foggiest how to do that sort of thing. And we're starting to see some blowback. If you remember in September, there were severe rolling blackouts in California. California is now 20% solar. And when it gets to 6 at night, the sun goes down, and so they lose all their electricity, a lot of their electricity. And then if they have a power plant go out or something, they're in deep trouble. Texas as well. They have an icing situation down there, and the wind turbines have just shut down. And they're the biggest wind turbine state in the nation in terms of total turbines. I think Iowa is close in per capita, but... So I'm afraid people are going to have to learn the hard way on this. It's sorry to say, but we're going to have brownouts. We're going to have higher electricity prices. Not a good situation moving forward.
If people want to find out more about you, Steve, where do they go?
Yeah, they can go to stevegoreham.com, my website. I'll send them a signed copy of one of my three books if they like. They can go find the books in Amazon and all around. A lot of fun to read. Color sidebars, 150 color sidebars, cartoons by artists, and they'll learn the real story on energy, climate, public policy.
Are you working on the next one?
I am. I've started a fourth one.
Ah, I knew it.
It's going to be on renewables. Yeah, well, I couldn't speak much last year. Everything was shut down, so I decided, well, I got to get started on a fourth book. So it's like climbing a mountain, though. I don't know if you've tried that before, but it's a big job. So
yep. No, I'm looking forward to the next one. Steve Goreham is the executive director of the Climate Science Coalition of America. He's author of three books, soon to be four. And the next one is very interesting to people in the Midwest because of those renewables. He's our guest regularly on this subject. We love having him on. Steve, thank you very much. We will talk to you again,
thank
my friend.
Thank you, Simon.
Stay warm. Yes, exactly. Stay warm wherever you are, my friend. All right. Thank you very much to Steve. What did you make of that? We haven't actually touched, by the way, the giant stack of stuff yet. Haven't touched it. How about that? And we've only got a two-hour show today. We're across the great state of Iowa and the Midwest. If you've got pets outside, bring them in!